DJ Star.
What up, Florida?
What up, Peter? What up? Back one more time with Lil Fro.
Lil and Fro should never go in the same sentence.
I mean, it's a Lil Fro.
It's a ponytail.
Trying to get the Wi-Fi straight. Okay, that's better. Better lighting.
I put the ring light up, like closer to me.
Yeah, that's better lighting. Just put it over a little bit because we can see the corner of your bedroom.
You can see my bed. That's my bed.
Yeah.
You look at it.
It don't matter. We I think they have a fun idea who Kuda is.
Oh,
hold on, because I'm stuck in the ring light now. Hold on. Yo, what is good?
Doing great. All right, well, we back. Cal Podcast, one more episode before 2022.
Yay.
But we had to do a Christmas edition. So, Merry Christmas to the people out there.
Merry Christmas, guys. Kurt,
on the road driving back home. I forgot he was driving. I don't remember if he told me. So, but we back. Kuda, how you doing?
I am great. I'm doing good.
Doing good.
I'm tired. Aaron's got their money's worth out of me today.
I see. Hey, I about to call you, but I was like, I don't even know. Is it $5 down for a PS5?
No, sir. It's not.
What was it?
The PS5s are $165 a month, so you have to pay the full month to get the PS5.
So what was the $5 for?
The $5 is a promotion on other stuff. They can pay $5, like, if they need a stove, a refrigerator, laptop. I can even do $5 down on a 55-inch TV.
Time out. Haven't me and you talked about laptops?
I can't help you. I'm not in your area.
But you did at the store.
What that mean?
Can't you ship it? You like one deal.
Mm-mm.
So I have to literally come there and pick it up.
You have to be in my area.
Oh, that sucks.
Your area is doing $5 down. It's nationwide.
I don't know them. I know you. And if something go wrong, I need you to like extend me out for maybe like a month or two if I miss a payment.
I don't do that. I just sell.
But you can do that. I hate that.
I'm not in accounts. I just sell. Oh, my Christmas hat. I couldn't put my hat on with my...
Don't put that on.
Here you go. Let me school jump some. Oh. So precious. Oh my gosh, DeMar is coming to Gravediggers Sirachmas Saturday.
Seen all that. You got a lot of people on there.
Yeah.
So we in the Christmas mode. We got Christmas, when y'all see this, which should be tomorrow. Christmas will be that day. No, the next day. I'm trying to see what else. Yeah, so when this get loaded, Christmas should be the next day. But we're going to do a Christmas edition of the podcast. I think the last time we did, it was like cheering up Perk.
Yeah. So what you got? What you doing this time?
Right now, it's for us. Damn him. He good now. He on the road headed back home. Last time, because he was stuck in Oklahoma. So he had a roll now, so damn him. We ain't cheering on Perk nothing. Matter of fact, I think if it wasn't for the Cal Podcast, he probably would have committed suicide. I'm just gonna put that on the record.
Nah, bro.
We save lives out here, Quita. We save lives. That man was stuck in Oklahoma by himself for Christmas. He ain't even had a dog yet.
He didn't. Damn, Perk.
So we say a lot. So, you know, kudos to us. We did that thing. So, first order of business up, though, is, where is it?
I'm scared.
Yeah, this BS right here.
Oh, what's wrong with that? Wait, okay, so first of all, let me say something. This is when my mom fixed it the next day. Everything there is cold. That's why it looks like that. Everything.
Not cold, but Quita, why do you have a plate
What?
To separate your food.
Because I don't like for my food to touch. I'm not going to eat it.
This is bougie.
It's not bougie.
Where do they find this at?
It's a preference. That's actually like a party tray that they have at Dollar Tree. I can't believe you saved that freaking picture. I could have got you a better picture.
First of all, I don't need a better picture because it's everything has its own corner off. So you got your macaroni, you got your cranberry, you got your turkey. Is that dressing in the middle?
Dressing in the middle. Then this is rice, broccoli, and cheese. Like, this is a horrible picture. This doesn't even look good right there.
I don't even care about it looking good. The fact that you got this, like, is it?
Okay, because the thing is, like, everything would have to go in bowls if she would have fixed it. So she just put it on this plate for me so my husband can bring it to me.
This is Quita, y'all, with the nasty Snapchat.
This is the plate that I used for Thanksgiving when I came over because I wasn't sure if mama had the plates with the compartments, the trays.
Yep, and just to prove everything.
That's my mom. Hi, mom.
Even her mom was like, damn shame.
I had somebody to say on, see, everything looks a little bit better right there. See, I ain't even getting no candy. And I was mad about that, too, because they couldn't fit on the...
Okay. Even your mom was like, it's a damn shame. Look how she
looks. But, dude, like, on the status, like, it was a lot of people like, hey, where'd you get that? I need that. I'm not the only one.
Man, when you get the... Okay, so when you fixing plates, especially for Thanksgiving and Christmas, the juice is supposed to come together. That what makes it what it is.
If it has juice, it's going to go either in a cup or a bowl. It's not going to go on the same plate with the rest of my dry food.
So you don't put your baked beans and macaroni together?
No.
Shrimp, I don't even... rice?
No. I've never heard of that before, and no.
Greens and rice?
No. I don't even eat greens and cornbread.
Quita, you from Art? And I forgot, Utah. That's the Utah in you. That's the Utah in you.
I'm from Arkansas.
That's the Utah right there. Because everybody from the South eat. Well, I take that back. Because people in Louisiana don't eat their rice with their greens. And I was like, what the hell is wrong with y'all?
Who eats rice with greens? Other than you.
Probably the whole damn state of Florida. Georgia too. South Carolina.
Are y'all considered the South?
Yeah, we deeper than y'all. Don't forget Florida at the bottom. So don't even get it twisted with the South, but
Southeast.
It whatever you want to call it, you still gotta put the South first.
People on Snapchat was like, yeah, you don't never show us what you're eating. I'm like, because I eat like a kid. Like,
don't, and you shouldn't. You shouldn't. First of all, I don't like when people post pictures of food, unless it's like in a restaurant. Mm-hmm. Like, some people home cook food. I'm like, what? They trying to kill y'all. Like, that stuff don't even look cooked.
That food just looked disgusting. Like, I would have never put that picture up there.
That picture is for the tray. The food I didn't really care for. But it's the fact that that's how you have to eat your food.
So?
Anyways, Quita, what did you get your husband for Christmas? And don't say pussy.
It is a gift.
What did you get your husband for Christmas?
Nothing.
Why not?
I haven't done anything. I'm off tomorrow.
You going shopping tomorrow?
Mm-hmm.
Quita, you really suck. Okay, so let's go back. What was the first Christmas gift you ever gave your husband? Like when you're in y'all dating stages?
Probably clothes. Because I didn't like the way he was dressing. So what I did was I bought the clothes and I put the outfits together. That way you know how to wear it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm sure it clothes. He had a Galaxy watch, a Samsung watch.
Who was Summer?
Summer. I don't, Chastity's friend Summer.
I don't know her.
You don't know Summer?
I don't think so. Tell her to get on. We're real talk. Tell her to get on. So, yeah, tell her to get on.
I gotta send her the info real quick.
Yeah, I'll put in a group text with Perk. He's driving, so whatever. What's one of the weirdest gifts you ever got for Christmas?
I don't think I've ever gotten a weird gift for Christmas.
Like from a random, like let's say from like a dude that was trying to shoot a shot at you, and he's like, I'm gonna get her a Christmas gift.
Nope. Never. I'm lame. Like, I've had people buy me jewelry, stuff like that, but. Oh, Chris, I need to look at Chris. Yeah. But no, nothing weird. What about you? What was the weirdest thing you've gotten? See? You got to think way back.
I do a tool set.
Why is that weird?
I was 12.
Oh.
I'm going to do it a tool. Like, I had a full grown man tool set at 12. You know, nothing what I'm doing. I'm like, what am I doing with this? Only thing I needed was a screwdriver, and that was just like take the screws off my toys to put the batteries in. I got a full blown tool set at the age of 12.
And don't say full blown like that, because it sounds like we was going somewhere else with.
Oh no! It was a full blown, like, you know, like the ones where you open it and fold out. I had every last single wrench. Like, I didn't know what none of this stuff was.
It sounded like you had a socket set.
I did. I had sockets. I had tweezers. What you call them things where the police use? The wristies?
Zip ties.
I had zip ties. I had all that. The only thing I really knew what to use was a screwdriver. And then, like, we put it in the garage, and I think it got stolen. But I'm like, I never used it. And so when I needed it.
That's cray cray.
When I got older.
A damn tool set.
Like, I knew what I was doing. The only thing I knew was the screwdriver. So, now what I have done, and I do this a lot. I didn't do it this year because I ain't really talking to nobody. I always get a Victoria set for somebody for Christmas.
Good job.
I always get a bra and thong. Always. I've been doing that for years.
Why does it have to be a thong?
Because I'm buying it. That's why.
Oh. So are you going to get to see it?
See, that's the thing. Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I do.
Okay. Can I receive it this year?
I don't want to see you in it. I do it for people.
But you just said sometimes you do, sometimes you don't.
Yeah, but listen, you married. I'm trying to make maybe somebody like, oh, no, I can't. Let me not say her name.
Cash doll pregnant.
She still look good pregnant. I still hit it. She still look good pregnant. You seen her? Like, she still look good pregnant. That girl is just beautiful all around.
Oh, these wings. Hot.
I would do it for I would do it for a woman that I want to see it in.
Okay, so I need to put this on Snap. You know what? I'll just record it. I'll screen record it so I can put it on Snapchat. Oh,
you can snap it right now. I repeat it. Go ahead. Get your phone ready. You get your phone ready. I'll say it right
you
now.
You know what? Here. I don't even have to do that. I can just put on there that Florida will buy a bra and thong say that if he can see you in it.
Live.
And they'll probably slide up and be like, oh, yeah. I'll do it.
But it got to be live. Not no
so Zoom, they got to come to Florida.
Pretty much. Pretty much. I mean, when I was in Louisiana, it happened for me.
Ooh.
Louisiana, I did it. Yeah. Florida.
Okay, so wait. Because I don't think you've seen my snap when I asked the question. But do you know anything about face sitting?
Like when a woman sit on your face?
Just sitting. Like, basically, your face is in her ass.
She's just sitting there like it ain't nothing. Like the dude just sitting there like it. Yeah, I don't do all that. That's some freaky stuff.
Oh my gosh. It's a fetish.
Yeah, some dudes get down like that.
Like, you let me tell you. Yeah, because I had somebody that asked me, they was like, if you can find somebody to do this for me, because, you know, I don't link with the fans. So, but I mean, I had a few people say that they were interested in doing it. It's just they're not in Louisiana.
A girl want to do that?
No, it's a man. It's a man. Oh. But he's also into, like, buying panties. So.
Why won't he just go on Twitter? That's where all that nasty stuff be.
It's not nasty. It's just different.
Well, I'm just saying. It's somebody fun land. Let me put it like that. This is a weird Christmas episode, but we're going to keep it rolling. It's somebody fun land. And if that's what they like, that's what they like.
This is a weird Christmas episode.
Yeah, we started off with Christmas giving and we ended up here, but I'm with it. Perk ain't here. You can't control me. Christmas edition, baby.
Oh my gosh. So we just be out here winging it because Perk's not here.
I mean, he probably would have logged off or said something by now.
Oh, snap. I need to make me an HS shirt like that. That's cute.
My t-shirt lady did it.
Oh, dude, you should have told me he was getting that done. I would have made me one.
I got this. Okay, real talk, dude. The reason why this shirt is special to me, I got this made for Star Funeral.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. She did this for me. Like, all my HS shirts, I fold up, but this one, I literally hang it up when I'm done.
You hang it up? Okay. Okay. It's special to you.
Yeah, I don't work out in it. I don't do it. Like, I put it on to rock as an outfit.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So, today is Grave Digger's birthday, right? And he asked that people share videos of Star. I'm not sure if you've seen it or not. So, when you get off of here, share a video to Star. Oh, Star to Grave.
Man, tell Gray to go to hsntglobal.com.
Oh, I thought you was about to say something else.
No, go to HST Global on Instagram. The videos out there, he can repost them.
It's so, like, I miss my homies, though.
Yeah. Crazy. Going on 2 years. Next month, the 26th. Lost my dog.
Yeah, it's going on 2 years. That's been a quick 2 years, too.
Literally, I think.
Like, what happened to this year, period?
Shit, COVID. It looked like we're about to go back on lockdown again. And I'm be honest with you, I'm cool with it.
Are you?
I
don't think they're going to do it. I don't think they're going to do it.
Let this COVID. Rise or spike, what is called everybody call it, it's the Omicron, but everybody been calling it the Omarion virus. Let 50,000 people, maybe 30, let between 30 and 50,000 people die from the Omarion, we'll be shut down. Because if we would have shut down early before we did, I don't think that many people would have passed away.
From COVID? I mean, honestly, yeah, I mean, okay, so They knew about it in China, and y'all knew that it was coming this way. Like, how could you not know it's coming this way when people travel? Like, okay, so we waited till freaking March to even shut down.
And let's not forget, if it wasn't for sports, and I always tell people, the reason why the country shut down is because sports canceled. If you're going to cancel sports, I mean, hey, what is everybody else doing?
I can't see it. I don't see it happening. They're too money hungry.
That's the thing, though. Look how much money people lost.
I know.
So if you were to shut down earlier, your company could have probably saved a little bit more money. Because what they did like is because now people realize I don't have to come to work every day to make money. And then what they also realized is people realized that they was getting underpaid. Only the coronavirus, it spiked up. Like, you have to, like, McDonald's went from 8 to 11 to 12. I mean, you got Hobby Lobby now charging. Hobby Lobby was only charging giving $7.50. Now they're up to what, $17 to come work at Hobby Lobby?
And really?
Yeah. And then people right
now. I need some help.
Everybody hired.
I ain't got time for it, though.
Everybody is hiring, because you know why? People like, I ain't finna come to work for no $10, $11.
No, because a lot of people around here make $7 to $8.
Would you go to work for that?
I haven't worked for $8 in a long time, so.
You know what I'm saying? I can't. And then you got more money
The child tax credit?
Not child tax credit. Unemployment.
Hell yeah. Yes.
So why go to work when you can make more money in unemployment than you did at your regular job?
That's a true fact, bro.
So yeah. I guarantee you 20,000 people in America, they'll shut us down because they already know. One, people ain't gonna come back to work, and two, that unemployment, they're gonna have to put money in now.
Yeah.
Only thing I'd be mad is the gym. I know the gym, they're gonna close the gym.
So you want everything to be shut down but the gym?
Yeah. Because I mean, when I go to the gym, I wear a mask anyway. So.
And then all these people acting like they vaccinated and they're really not.
They're not. And that's why I wear a mask in the gym.
This chicken is hot. I don't know if I'm smacking or not. I'm sorry, you guys.
It's the Cow Podcast. It's food. We're talking about food. So, the Christmas edition 2021. We can come back together just to give y'all a little something for the people. Give a quick shout out to but the Whataburger family. I ordered something off her website. What's the name of her?
Party Doll.
Yeah, her daughter. What's it? Mayel Monroe. Big shout out to Mayel Monroe. I'm gonna give a quick shout out to that company. I got a nice little dress for my sister, and I got a little cover for my cousin. And she sent me like some free pair of earrings since I bought some too. So big shout out to Maya Monroe. Y'all go check it out at Instagram.
Can we see the dress on?
I can go to the website because the dress is wrapped up.
Oh, wait. You just gonna announce it like that and it's for your sister?
I mean, she don't watch the podcast anyway.
Oh, well, damn.
So. I told her I was gonna get on one day, but it's all good. I just want to say my fam on these pictures, though. She be killing it. Let me just do this. See if I can find it.
Oh, my mouth burning. Whoa, that looked a little. Oh, wow.
This all her.
These are some cute pictures.
I know. I got the
dress. Yes, the white.
It was an on sale item, so don't judge me. It might be sold out. Oh, this right here, this Missy dress.
Okay. Click it up.
Yeah, please follow her on IG at Maya Munro. Oh, let me say how it should be pronounced. Maya Maron. She got a Missy dress. You can pay in 4 interest-free installments of order between $50 and $3,000. So you don't have to pay the whole price up. She has that going. And she only has it in 2X and 3X for all my big girls out there. No more 1Xs.
Mm-hmm. You're doing a great job, Flo.
I know. Hey, we got to get these people. We got to get these sponsors and ads. What? It's another piece I bought. Where is that? I think I bought something for what a swimwear. There we go. Now these the pictures right here.
Okay.
Look. Okay. I'm gonna just show this picture. I didn't buy this, but I just want to show this picture. My dog out here, dog. You feel me? Look at it. Look. Cheeks are out, baby.
Oh, my gosh. That is cute. I like that cover up.
Mm-hmm. Look. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Get that cover up.
This is my dog. This is what I got my cousin. Because she be wearing little skimpy bikinis and stuff like that. So she can put that on the cover herself.
Why she got a cover? Deja vu, okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Maya Maro. y'all go to her IG, man. She got a lot of good stuff. Now she ain't got no thong bikinis, but
ooh, yeah.
Hold on, we're gonna show
her. I like that picture.
Jumpsuits and ruffles. Here we go. Mm-hmm, ladies.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna go through all the pictures. Side view.
Okay.
Back okay. view. Mm-hmm. Back to the front. Yes. This is my dog. And she gonna hate me for this, but if you zoom in, bingo.
Stop.
It's Pierce. Now you will like this one, Quita.
And do have all the big girl roles hanging out. That's
ladies
cute.
And, ladies and gentlemen, Maya Monero. Make sure y'all follow her on IG. Make sure y'all go check out. She got a lot of good stuff. She got a lot of stuff. I think she has something else, but I was like, that is too much.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
dude, it was
too funny, bro.
Yes. That's her IG. Make sure y'all go follow her and show her some love. She got some good stuff. Well, this pic right here was just,
that army jacket was cute with the lips on it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So y'all check her out, man. She got some good stuff on there, man.
Mm. Ah. Facts.
So that's why I got my cousin and my sister. I said I'm gonna support Black and go to her website because I was sure finna go to Ross and buy something. So,
Florida, you funny, bro.
Bro, I just wanna go to Ross. I just wanna go to Ross and be in that women's section looking for stuff, asking for women. You like this? That's a good way to talk to women too because they know you don't know what you're doing. So you just ask them a question: do you like this?
So you just somebody walk by like, hey, you like this?
Like, I'm like, would you wear this?
Okay.
But you ask the cute you don't ask the cute girls, you ask like older women. Uh-huh. And that's when you go to the cute like you be talking like, would you okay, what about you? No? And then it's just a conversation.
Okay.
This is real life.
You ain't never, well, I forgot, you married. Whatever you got to do to get a conversation going.
Okay. Okay.
Because the conversation, who knows? You might get the number, be at the register. Hey, look, I don't know if you're doing anything, but you know, can we exchange numbers? See what you like, go to the movies. This is what we single people do out here for Christmas. So Quita, what would be a good Christmas? Hold on.
No. Don't ask for a number. Just ask for the social media handles.
For what?
Because, like, most women are going to be hesitant to give you their number that quick.
I mean, if she say yes, she say yes. If she say no, she say no.
So now we don't have a social media or her phone number.
Who cares? It's more women out there.
Oh, cocky.
It ain't cocky. It's just... I had a girl I was talking to this literally after Three-Headed Monster.
Okay.
I think her name was like Dorothy or something. She went to ground. Matter of fact, she was from Nebraska. And I was like, I didn't know Nebraska made women like this. But we was talking. I was like, well, let me get your number. And she was like, oh, I can't, but find me on social media. I'm like, I'm not finna go searching for you. She told me that on a Saturday. Tuesday, I see her in the calf. I ain't even speak to her.
Such an asshole.
Don't tell me to go find me on social media.
Just add me on Facebook. Add me on Snapchat.
She said, find me on Instagram.
Okay.
I'm like, I'm not finna go searching.
We're buying it.
Probably high. I'm throwing it. Whoever you ask, I'm gonna give you like an obscene answer.
I'm not finna do this. Ask
about somebody else.
No.
So Queen.
Pain.
Selling dope.
Live.
He's probably waxing his underarms.
Why would you pick that for him? Lip.
He working. When I'm talking about working, he working. He like working for like $8 an hour or some shit.
TJ.
Oh, TJ? TJ having Bible study.
So is this just what's coming to your mind first? Because I wouldn't have said Bible study for TJ.
Whatever popped in my head as soon as you say the name.
Dynasty.
Twerking naked, but she cooking shrimp. Sue drinking with a woman, I can tell you that. But she got on like boxer briefs with the hole in the front and a wife beat on.
Definitely that. Man, where's Sue at? I need to take Sue.
Sue definitely wear boxer briefs with the holes in the front.
I don't like you right there.
Mm-hmm.
With the holes in the front?
Yeah.
Sophie.
She reading.
Okay. Dominique?
She's scratching her head right now for some reason. I don't know why.
Ashley. Mulan. Let me say Mulan. Because you probably was like, where Ashley?
Okay. Mulan. She on the toilet. I just got a feeling.
Okay. Lainey. Where's Taryn? Taryn, let me see. I'm gonna take both of them.
Taryn is somewhere drinking a beer like a man. Lainey is probably on the internet watching cartoon porn.
Cartoon porn?
Mm-hmm. Like, she probably watching it too with the covers on top of the laptop, even though she in an apartment by herself.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm.
So.
No. No. Who I say? Dominique.
She, Dominique is literally, she's scratching
her head. Scratching her head. You did say
I don't know why. She's like, Dominique is literally scratching
her
head.
You went back to that, that she's scratching her head.
Like, she's literally scratching her head. I don't know why, but Dominique is scratching her head right now.
Miss Love and Big Purr.
Miss Love, I can tell what she's doing right now. She getting herself ready for summer. When I mean she getting herself ready, she putting on makeup, like even her chest, she gonna have that poked out and everything. Like, Miss Mama gonna get herself right. Who else you said?
Big Purr.
Big Purr, she probably got a head wrap on, big t-shirt, watching reruns of Girlfriends.
Girlfriends, yes. He called me Big Purr. Come make this.
Like, she probably drinking wine out of coffee mug.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's Christmas, man. It's getting close to it. Single people. What would you be some good advice you give single people going into Christmas?
Advice single people? Mm-hmm. As in what? Like, just live your life.
Like, they single, they going into another Christmas, no boo, no bae. Maybe got like a little something on the side, but they like, I don't want to make it real with this person.
Damn. Live your life until you're ready. Like, just turn up. That's gonna be my everything. We didn't survive COVID thus far. We've come this far by faith. So we're gonna turn up every chance we get.
My suggestion is, man, do you.
Exactly.
Just do you. Have fun.
Do whatever makes you happy.
To all the older women out there, you know how to get in contact with me. Follow me on IG. Let me add that boy, Florida. Let me tell Kurt.
How old are we talking when you say older women?
36 to 44.
How old are you? You're 36?
I'll be 35 on the 14th.
I didn't know you were younger than me.
I don't know why people think I'm older. I just hang with older people.
You have an old soul.
Pert, Star, Pat, all older than me. I'm literally the baby out of all four of them. Literally the baby.
Pat, what's Pat doing right now?
Pat playing video games, and he's probably eating chicken tenders.
Who else we had on here?
Come on.
I'm trying to think. What is Share your and Sean. Sean rolling up.
Both of them rolling up, but Shayo ain't got no shirt on, and he probably watching Family Guy. Sean probably cleaning his Omega boots while smoking.
So if Perk was driving, what would he be doing?
Perk probably sitting on the couch rubbing his stomach.
I said something about his stomach, too.
He probably somewhere like this. Just rubbing like the right... the right hemisphere of his stomach. And then he's like, let me just move down. Don't forget about the central area on my stomach.
Oh my God.
All he's doing is whatever he ate, he massaging it down so he can eat again.
Nah, bruh.
Yeah. What time is it? It's like 10, 11. If he was in Oklahoma, yeah, he getting ready for ice cream.
That's so what wait. Big, that's how what far big is he? Do.
I don't Unless he on the phone with somebody.
When did he get on the road?
I think he got on early, like 11 a.m.
And how long does it take him to get home?
Shit, that's a drive from Oklahoma to Mississippi. Because he probably went through, I'll take that back. He maybe went the back way instead of coming through Dallas and hitting 20. Mm-hmm. I don't know. He might have took Tulsa to 55. I don't know. It might be a faster going through Dallas. Who knows? He might be stopping somewhere to get some.
Great idea, Bert. So your royal oats.
So
you don't have boo for Christmas?
Nah. I'm chilling. I told you that.
You chilling.
If something happened, I mean, I'm down for whatever.
Okay, it's whatever.
If I get a phone call. I tell you what, I usually... I usually get phone calls around about after Christmas going into the new year.
And or?
Like random, like females I used to talk to.
Woman.
I guess give a shot. But I always be like, I just want to have sex. Because like when I wanted to be with you, you kind of pushed it off. But now all of a sudden you give me a shot now, and it's like,
is this a pinky ring? It's a pinky ring.
Yeah. I've been had it.
It just caught my attention.
Anyway, so they always sometimes I be like, when I wanted to talk to you, you kind of push me off, but. Nah, that's like a problem I was like when talking to women. Like when I wanted to be with you, it was like, nah, I don't think it's gonna work out. But now you wanna give me another shot and I'm like, I'm past it.
Yeah.
Then I just be real asshole.
But why do you still wanna have sex with them?
They still look good.
You don't want anything with them, but you just want them smashed.
They still look good.
So what if you've already been there before? Would you still come back and smash again?
Depends on who the person is and how good it was.
Okay. So what if you don't remember how good it was?
You can keep it. You can definitely keep it. Because if it was like Quita, I'm at the age where, and if I'm talking to any woman over the age of 27, we're at the point in our life, right now, just turning it from the Cow Podcast to Quita After Dark, I just want to point that out. I'm at that age, and like, if you don't know what you're doing in the bedroom by now, it is something wrong with you. I've been saying this for the longest. I said, if the only two positions you know is for a man to get on top, and him hitting it from the back, baby, you are a hoe. Those are hoe moves. Like, Quita, it's got to come a time where you, like, literally throw your man down and get on top of him and ride him like he ain't never been rolled before. Like, you got to know positions by now. You got to,
you are so passionate about this. It's so funny.
Yes, because I'm like, yo, what is this boring? Like, yo, who's still doing this 18 in the car section? Like, yo, it comes a time in life where, like, you watch Living Single.
Yes.
Everybody thought Max was a hoe.
Yeah.
And I was like, at the point growing up, I'm like, yeah, but now, well, imagine, I'm like, nah, Max just confidence in her sex game. She know what she like. She know what she want. And the crazy part or not, when dealing with older women, I see more Maxines than ever.
Mm.
Like, I know it's a lot of women know what they want and know when they want it, and they know how they want it. So I'm like, if we finna do these same positions, it's I promise you, I hit it, but don't expect a phone call back. Like, it's boring. Like, yo.
So she asks why, you're gonna tell her why?
Yeah, like, like that whole side of you, be that with me every time. I want that.
Yeah.
I like that. That lets me know, like, yo, when we go on these trips, you down to, like, if we go somewhere like Cancun, and I said, let's do it on the beach, you down for it. Ain't always got to be in the hotel room. But, like, you're going to have to do something. Like, why you think all these men be cheating on their wives?
Oh, yeah.
Because it's boring.
It is.
Like, nobody, who wants that? Like, no, if you don't want a boring relationship, why would you want a boring sex life?
It can get boring.
Like, yeah, I can't, I just, if you over the, like, even if you never been with that many people, I know you got sex toys. I know you done practice. I know you done practice.
Like me, like, I don't care for toys. So, like.
But I'm saying, though, if you, like, you got a full grown husband. Dude. Some women ain't got husbands or boyfriends. So I'm like, I know you got sex toys. Go ahead and practice on that. So when you do get with that guy, you can show like, hey, I'm a good woman.
But like, okay, so this another issue. So if the toy is this daggone long, this wide.
That's why you got to be smart with the situation, knowing that all that and out there in the world.
I mean, it's long. You're supposed to sit on it.
Quita, the one chick, the last chick I've been with, she told me,
you come ain't on, the man.
Whoa, Sue.
I'm here.
Anyways, so quick. So the
he
so,
said what?
There goes Sue. What up, Sue?
Is she drinking?
Where you at, Sue?
Working the door at a party.
Oh, she's not drinking.
You making money? Oh, you. Quita talk bad about you. I just want to point that out.
Sue, never Sue.
Quita said you was home in a white beater and some boxer shorts drinking with your babe.
You can run it back. Yeah. But no, I did not say that.
I'm drinking Santa.
What part are you working, Sue?
We do this party in Lafayette on Wednesday called Rooftop Wednesday. The club is a couple of levels, and the top level is on the roof. So hookah, cigars, we got a bar on the roof, we got a DJ.
You booking it for your birthday?
Nah, I'm doing Shisha, which is another club in Lafayette, for my birthday on that Friday the 14th. It's a blackout.
You mean my birthday, right?
Yeah, your birthday. My birthday is Saturday, but
thank you.
We're not doing rooftop because I'm doing, I just wanted to, so that Friday, we're going to do, it's this spot in Lafayette called Shisha, and it's a blackout. Y'all know black and red, my favorite color. So.
Okay.
Sue, what's a good Christmas gift to give somebody for Christmas that you're trying to get their attention?
Nothing.
A Pandora bracelet. What? Sue, the fuck?
That's the best way to get somebody attention. Don't buy them that. Then they're going to want to know why you ain't buying them that. I can't talk. I've been sipping my ass off. This girl got her nails done today. And she got all kinds of stuff. Yeah, I'm officially single now, yeah.
Oh, like that's something new.
You saw Queen's face?
Like that's something new.
Nah, for real. Like
Sue. First of all, for people that don't know, Sue be out here, man. Sue, you'll see Sue with one chick. I'm be honest with you. I follow Sue Instagram. I'll be like, God, this one and that one. I don't think you'd be single too much longer.
Nah, I bet somebody $1,000 I'll be single until March.
Till March?
Yeah, you gotta get past Valentine's Day. So I give you the 18th.
That's low down. That's low down, Sue.
What? It's I'm living. Yeah, you could. Yeah, you could.
She gonna be single purposely on Valentine's Day.
No, like did you see the little chick that I'm kind of talking to? I'm gonna send you a picture of her.
Send it to Quita. Quita, I ain't seen.
The tall one?
I don't know how tall it is.
I don't think Quita's phone number saved in this phone. Quita, you got my 972 number?
Huh? You want me to text?
Text my 972 number.
Hold on. Nope, I don't have a 972 number.
I got you.
Oh, we got multiple phones.
It's Sue, boy. Dog, niggas be really sleep on Sue.
I just sent you a picture of me.
I told you how many women has Sue flipped. That's a real question. So,
I'm sorry.
Oh, damn, I keep touching it. Hold on, let me get Big Purr real quick. Let me get it together.
What you doing with her?
My future.
Hold on.
Hey, I'm not letting Big Purr in this episode because this is going to turn into a rant for her.
It is not. It's not. Florida, don't do it.
I'm not letting her on. I'm just letting you know that.
She was at district.
Okay, so. Is this the one that was I'm scared to say something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's her. You know I gotta fuck with if I'm trying to sell her shit.
Yeah.
Look, she win, we all win. That's how the thing is. So look, if y'all need some sex talk, y'all hit me up. I got it.
What's her IG? We'll promote it.
It's I don't think she posted it on IG, but we don't follow each other on social media.
Let me go follow.
Yeah.
What's her IG?
I don't follow. You see that? I'm gonna text it to you. I know it, but it's private. She may not accept your friend request.
Don't worry, I'll do it for you. I got you, see. You know, I
gotta remember it.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, I don't remember it.
It's all good.
I take that too. You gonna find her?
We ain't doing nothing. I just need to know how she what's it like. Give me a couple letters. I'll find her.
So, Florida, have you ever stopped dating someone because the holidays is coming up?
No.
You, Sue?
Me, yeah.
No, I'm a
simp, y'all. If I fuck with you, I fuck with you.
Yeah, me too.
Like, that's how, I'm not even going to call it simping. That's her hair page, Florida. She do hair, too. I'm not gonna even call it simping. I just look at it like, if I rock with you, like if I fuck with you on that level, I got you. That's at any type of level. Like, you know, like with her, me and her not in a relationship, but she told me what she wanted for Christmas, and shit, I'm gonna make it happen.
Dolled up, okay.
I have never stopped talking to somebody for the holidays. Why would I want to stop talking during the holiday? That's when the time most people get the most freakiest.
Oh.
Right. You want to talk to them after the... You want to stop after the holiday's over when they get back hot outside.
Like, you know my ideas I got in my head for Valentine's Day? I'm just waiting to let all this shit out on somebody.
So I'm trying to say...
Why we stopping in the summer?
Because it's hot girl summer.
It's been hot girl summer. It always been hot girl summer. Meg Thee Stallion just brought the freak out, which Meg Thee Stallion said, be a thot, but go home to your man.
It's hot girl summer 24/7 around here. We in Louisiana, it's always tight. It's cold today, though.
They still gonna dress skimpy no matter what the weather is.
Oh, you should see they had some bartenders just walk up from the other club that we be at, kind of drink. But like I said, being that it's on the roof and it's kind of cold outside, people got clothes on.
So they're really
I wish out. I could
come. God, oh, bro.
Yeah, we good. Well, Sue, we ain't gonna hold you up. We appreciate you getting on.
Something
happened. What up? I guess you're on. All right, well, yeah.
You finna do booter? Give her the boot.
Oh. No, I didn't leave. It put it in sit driving mode or something.
Driving mode.
Driving mode.
Okay.
Yeah. What's up?
How much
is it? But, you don't want a band, huh? 20.
We literally watching transactions go down.
Certified hustlers. Love it.
Well, yeah, we saw all this.
It's really the rooftop, though.
Yeah, we saw all that.
So that's Blake.
Hey, Blake.
He do Wednesdays at Rooftop. You know, this is his thing on Wednesdays and stuff. So, yeah, they play. If y'all, they said Roger was supposed to come, but they call. Huh? Yeah, and that's why I text you. But they paid. They were supposed to talk about. Oh, I'm like,
security guard call.
Y'all be paying like $20. I don't know that.
Sue.
Huh?
Sue, we'll holler at you, man. We're gonna let you get your ass back to work.
Hi.
Yeah.
That's.
Sue out here doing real things.
Sue ain't getting his money, bro.
Yeah. But yeah, I'm real passionate when it comes to that part, Pooty. I'm real passionate. I just think as a woman over the age of 30, you should be knowing what you're doing. It shouldn't be boring no more. And the crazy, nah, because dealing with these type of women, like, I have met so many. I first of all, when coming up, when they girls used to say, I don't give head, I was like, man, you got to find the right one to get it, and not enough, you got to find a bus down. You know how many bad chicks love doing that?
Yeah.
Like, they really love it. So that's why I'm like, yeah, over the age of 30, like, don't be shy with me. Give me all that. I promise you. I ain't the one going to go snitch on you. I'm going to be the one like, yo, you can't talk to her. It's just, once you find one that can meet your level and at your level, you ain't trying to tell the whole world about her.
Oh, child.
You trying to make sure you either wife her up or have her in rotation.
Not rotation. So how many girls do you have in rotation at one time?
Yes, I ain't the one who got a lot, though.
Okay, but how many? What's your max?
The max I probably have is probably 5.
That's a lot of.
Right, I mean, right now I'm only dealing with maybe 2.
I need to ask this on Snapchat. How many women do y'all usually keep in rotation?
I probably maybe had 2. Grad school, I had like 5.
So now, 5 is, you would see all 5 within a week or within 2 weeks?
In a week. final. You, it's different ways. You know, FaceTime here, meet me here, go here. Hey, let's go to Shreveport. We got a party in Monroe, stuff like that. Come by the crib. I got a cook.
What about smashing though? Like, how many would you smash?
I mean, it's just, it depends. Like some days, I mean, I ain't a dude that was player. Like I had something every day, maybe twice or three times a week, depending on which one.
Okay. I can respect that.
And then sometimes you're going to,
but it wasn't the same one.
Nah, sometimes you're going to dry spell 2 to 3 weeks. I mean, I think the longest I probably went, probably maybe like a year, because I just got the ground. Like that my
what is in Florida?
Sure, man. I just got the ground. I was just trying to figure my way out. So, and then like it was a rough time.
Okay,
but that, I mean,
a year is a long time.
It is. I mean, shoot, I remember when I came back home from school, I was trying to set something up, couldn't get nothing.
Damn,
that's why when I first got it, it was like. Look, you talking about Minute Man, it probably took me about like 45 seconds. It exploded everywhere.
So it doesn't help to go ahead and strip it out?
Because that's a different feeling. It is a different feeling. I don't care what you say. I don't care what man you're talking to. They can do that. Mm-hmm. Well, it's a different... This is rough from lifting weights and grinding on that iron. That's a different feeling. Can't no man imitate that feeling. No hand can do that.
Oh my God.
Look at your hands. Can they imitate what you've been getting?
No.
Come on now, let's be real. It's a different feeling. This right here.
But for us, it's different though, because like I'm a person that if I squirt, I can just keep going. Some people can't. They be, ugh.
That's why you got to practice.
I didn't have to practice. This is just something that just happens. But like y'all come there first time, be hard to get back up, or you got to wait.
No, and see, and that's another thing. You got to know your body. So a lot of dudes be out here be trying to fake it. Like for me, and I always say this, round one, you're going to win. Because I know my body. Once I'm in it, 45 seconds, maybe a minute 15, oh, it's happening. I'm busting.
No, Florida.
But I, round one, you're going to win. But round two, I'm going to wear you out. And to this day, I have not lost.
You didn't have a weight champ.
I have not. Round one is yours. I just know, and this is for any dudes younger, you gotta know your body. Round one, you're gonna win. But two, I'm gonna wear you out. Three, I'm gonna win. Four, I'm telling you right now, I'm getting a little limp. But two and three, I'm gonna win.
A little.
Oh, I'm getting limp. Just tell you right now. Look, I'm gonna get a little limp. But two and three, I promise you, you're not gonna beat. I promise you, I'm gonna wear you out. That, and that's why I be looking at some women like, dog, y'all don't know your bodies. You gotta know your bodies.
Ladies, there you have it. Round one is yours. Four possible, but two and three.
I'm gonna win.
Belongs to the heavyweight champ.
I haven't lost. Look, only reason why I say that, because I was with an older woman, and usually when I was doing it, it was like the first round, I thought it was over. And she was like, where you going? I'm like, I can't, that's it. She's like, you can't go again? I'm like, I don't know. And she's like, yes, you can't, look at you. You're getting it back up now. And I, after that, I knew my body. Hey, if you don't know, you don't know.
These older ladies, like, so do you be feeling some type of way when they tell you stuff? Would you just be like, oh, I never done this before?
I never. I because it's like it's literally like driving. It's like driving. Like, you have to have somebody to teach you how to drive. You just didn't hop in the car and start driving. Thanks. And that's why I look at a lot of older men when they get with younger girls. They don't, first of all, you shouldn't be with them. Second of all, I don't get that. But that girl don't know. And you ain't teaching her. What's the point? That's why older women, everything that, all my skills, I got from an older woman. Wow. That's why when I get with literally somebody my age or younger, I turn them out because they ain't never had this done before.
Oh. Turn them out. Okay, then, Florida. Wow. We're seeing a different side of Florida today.
Well, it's Christmas. We're going in 2022. Perk ain't here. It's just us vibing. We having a good time. Anything you want to tell the people for Christmas before we wrap this up, Queen?
Man, y'all be careful. Be safe. Enjoy your Christmas. Enjoy your family. Thank y'all for tuning in. Merry Christmas, Florida.
Merry Christmas, Queen. And to everybody out there, I want to wish you a happy Merry Christmas, a happy New Year. And before I finish and wrap this up, in 2022, whatever goals you have, go for it. If you would have told me we'd have been a year on this podcast, I probably would have said, yeah, you're right, because I know me, but we went for it. Don't short yourself whatever you want to do in life. Go get it. It's a bigger plan than what you want. Something big out there for you. So, like I always say, we're going to get better. Do better. Perk somewhere driving. That's Queen in Florida. And I have a good night. Do Cal Podcast. Merry Christmas and Happy got a dick round here. It's totally wrong. She get no frill. Yeah. Bitch, I'm a man. She's 14 classified. Got it from the dirt. That's like good. Sand. Word around town. Dog getting cash on the man. Had to get mine in the van. Ain't no pressure. Can't hold shit around here. Yeah. Hello, world. HSCT, you know how we do.